Hello there, how are you all doing?
I've mixed some Amsterdam titanium white with polypour and water. And maybe I used a little bit too much water, so I hope it won't crack, but we'll see. I'm trying to do today another abstract, but with a lot more color. And all the colors that I'm using today are from the Bright Bloom sampler set from Color Art with 12 primary element colors. They are just amazing and I want to use all 12 of them, so let's hope that I can keep it minimalistic with that much color. But of course I don't know, but we'll see. So I'm dividing my paint now. I don't want too much paint on here. I want it covered, but not too thick, because if you put a very thick layer on the bottom, all your paint will probably, or your colored paint will probably sink. Well, that's not what we want. Let me touch up the sides and I will pour off what I have too much on my canvas. So we will stay with a nice thin layer of white paint on the canvas. I'm just wiping my hands and I will torch the air bubbles with a creme brulee torch. I think that's what they call it. They use it to burn sugar on a dessert. But I think you have lighters that do the same thing too. Okay, well, the first thing I'm going to do is, and I hope this is all in frame, but I have a little card here and I'm planning to put black on that card. And that black is golden carbon black mixed with a little bit of Australian float roll. It doesn't matter what you mix it with, but this is what I had. And I'm trying to put that card in there, so I will have a super straight line. But, well, of course, I don't know if that will work, but I'm going to try. Okay, you see, here I have the black and I'm just going to put it straight on. Ooh, I'm shaking down in the white paint. And go straight back up. Okay, I have a black line, but it's not very equal, but okay. I can live with this. And then I will do another one. And I will put it down right here. And well, I think I did not use enough black paint, but well, we have a little line. I can always work on it some more later. And what I am planning to do now is I want to put some colors in this corner and in this corner. And I want the warm colors to be on one side and the cooler colors to be on one side. And I don't want to use too much, but well, that will be a challenge. Okay, I think I'm going to do the cool colors right here. And I'm going to start with the key lime. These are all the primary elements from the Bright Bloom's kit. It's a sampler set where you get 12 colors and your Vivid Enamel. And I did mix these with Vivid Enamel, by the way. So you know. Then I'm going to use Peacock Feather. Beautiful color. And I don't think you are seeing this now, but these colors are very shimmery. These are made from pigments and special micas. And well, these are just the most beautiful colors I have ever seen. And I cannot imagine doing my art without them. Here I have the sky blue. And of course I will show you a close-up after I'm done playing. So you can hopefully see the shimmer. Here we have the boysenberry. A gorgeous, very deep purple. I just adore this color. And so how are you guys doing? Are you still doing a lot of art? Are you still at home because of COVID? Or are you back to your work again? Or oh, tell me how you are. I like to know. Here we have the Wine and Roses, also one of my favorites. Gorgeous color. And we are ending this with Sapphire on Ice. Beautiful metallic dark blue color, just love it. And I'm planning to do some very tiny swipes. I think I will put down a little bit of yellow also. This is the sunflower. Just to brighten it up a little bit. This is too much. Okay. I have here all little pieces of card, and this is what I'm going to use to swipe. Very tiny swipes. Okay, first I'm going from the bottom here and I'm going straight up. So the beautiful colors will hopefully all mingle a little bit. And this is just my fantasy. It's not supposed to be anything, just some abstract artwork. As you can see, the color paint is pushing my black line a little bit back. Well, that was to be expected, but I don't mind. Okay, I'm going to leave that for now. And now we are going to do the warm colors on this corner. So I will turn around my canvas because it's easier for me to swipe toward myself. Let me see, here we have Passion, which is a gorgeous, well, magenta with violet magenta with a pearl shimmer, purple pearl shimmer in it. It's so beautiful. And here we have persimmon, a beautiful orange color with a golden shimmer to it. And let me see, here I have coral berry. Yeah, it looks like that's beautiful. It's not pink, it's not orange, it's really a coral color. Very pretty, at least I think so. And it will probably look the same, those two, but it's really, it's not. Here we have poppy red. Here we have ginger flower, a gorgeous, gorgeous purple. Let me see. Yeah, purple with a violet shimmer to it. Just love it. And here we have passion, which has a blue violet shimmer to it. Just a little more. And here we have the sunflower. And I know yellow is also a cold color, but it looks really beautiful with all that oranges, red and magenta. It's just a really good color combination. And now I'm going to do again the tiny swipes. So here we go. You see, I spilled a little bit there. That was not what I meant to do. But it's hard to do such tiny swipes. At least I think so. Because of medication, my hands are really shaky. And I always have a little problems with that. But I can tell you already, I think this is going to be beautiful. And I see that I did lose a lot of my black lines, but I will just do them again in a minute. Because I do want that black lines there. Oh my gosh, this is really pretty. Okay, I think I will just get my black and do this and hope I stay straight with my shaky hands. Okay, here we go. And now I'm going to do the same from, let me show you. And now I'm wondering is this okay or is it too minimalistic? But I do love it. I think I would put a drop of black here. Just a little. No, I think I'm going to restrain myself. This is it. I'm going to leave it like this. And I will show you, of course, the dried result. That will be tomorrow. And I will show you a close-up for now, so you can see the wet result. Okay, Saskia, stay away from it. I got to be harsh for myself. Leave it alone. That's just the hardest part there is, right? Okay, guys, I'm going to take off my gloves and I'm going to give you a close-up. Yes, here we are again. So, there you can see how nice and bright these colors are and so beautiful. Yeah, I just love it. The colors of this Bright Blooms kit are just incredible. And I'm going to do some blooms this week, probably, on rocks. And I will use just the same colors, but just look at this, how pretty this is. At least I think so. Okay, I really, really loved how it turned out, but my lovely husband dropped a tablecloth in my painting. But well, it was going to be beautiful, so I guess I'm going to do this again. I'm trying to show you the shimmer in that and that heart. But yeah, I actually really love this painting. I will try to get you a close-up of the dried paint. I love that blue here that bled into the white. I think it's giving it an extra dimension. I really love that. Yeah, I think this is really, really, really gorgeous. I'm so sorry this happened, but well, at least we know this is actually very fun to do, and I really love the result. Okay, I want to thank you for watching. If you want to buy those pigments, go to my website. You can find them there. And if you want to talk to me, look me up on Facebook or Instagram, and we will meet. Okay, bye bye.